Singles match on to court one, representing Canada, Michelle Lee. Representing Singapore, Xiaoyu Liang.
So the women's singles players make their way onto court. This is the last of the eight last 16 matches. All the other quarterfinal berths have been decided. So the number three seed, Michelle Lee, up against this lady who's caused such a sensation throughout the mixed team competition, Liang Xiaoyu of Singapore.
You receive? Okay. And you'll serve also.
So the toss of the coin completed. And what a match this promises to be. Women's singles last 16 encounter. The number three seed, Michelle Lee, up against the 18-year-old sensation representing Singapore, Liang Xiaoyu. So this from the top half of the draw. PV Sindhu yet to play her last 16 match, the number one seed. But whoever wins the match we're about to watch will play against Sarah Walker, the number seven seed from England. So Michelle Lee caused a bit of a sensation in the mixed team competition, didn't she? Because in the quarterfinal against India, she beat PV Sindhu in three games. That was sensational. Born in Hong Kong, but now lives in Toronto, the 22-year-old. Actually moved to Canada at the age of six. So her opponent, just a real youngster. But first of all, Michelle Lee, well, she had a bye in the first round, and then against Bashir of Pakistan in the second, it was 21-9, 21-4 in just 21 minutes. So very dominant in that women's singles, but lovely to see the woman player from Pakistan at these Commonwealth Games. Liang Xiaolu, 18 years of age, born in Nanjing in Jiangsu province, and only played four tournaments at senior level before coming to these Commonwealth Games. So she's had to play twice, first round against Kate Kukun, the left-handed player from Mauritius, 21-4, 21-3, and then against Diana Archer of Ghana, 21-4, 21-2. So she's only dropped 13 points in total during her first two matches. Girish Natu of India, our umpire for this one. Dhiraj Gunadre of Mauritius, our service judge. Well, Michelle Lee played in the Commonwealth Games in Delhi. She reached the quarterfinal stage before losing to a certain Elizabeth Can, who was representing England 4 years ago. And Elizabeth Can went on to take the bronze medal. And I was watching Elizabeth Can earlier today. She lost out to Sarah Walker, who is the player that the winner of this match will play against in tomorrow's quarterfinal.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Liang Xiaoyu, Singapore. And on my left, Michelle Lee, Canada. Michelle Lee to serve, Lovell Black.
So the number three seed, Michelle Lee from Canada, getting this last 16 encounter underway against the 18-year-old sensation from Singapore, Liang Xiaoyu.
Service over. One love.
When we all saw the draw, and certainly after we had watched a couple of matches of Liang Xiaoyu in the team competition, everybody was abuzz, and I know you and I were sitting down over a cup of tea discussing this potential match. Well, it's transpired, and this was one we were very much looking forward to.
I totally agree. This is one of the highlights of tonight in my book.
Yeah.
This match is really something else. And, you know, when you look at the draw, in my book, my humble book, I think there are perhaps four players that can win this tournament in the women's singles. And two of them are on the court now.
Yeah, I concur.
So this is very interesting. This could be the final. It's not the final, but it could have been the final. Depending on the draw and all that. But these two girls could have played one another in the final.
Now, perhaps I ought to just explain why they've met so early. Of course, Michelle Lee has been as high as 19 in the world ranking. Her opponent has only played four tournaments, senior tournaments. It's only senior tournaments that count towards world rankings. And therefore, Liang Xiaoyu, who's been playing World Junior Championships, twice a quarterfinal at World Junior level. And so, of course, her world ranking isn't that high, so she didn't get a seeded position because seedings are done straight from the world ranking.
Yes.
So that's why they've met so early on.
Yes.
And it's going to be a huge disappointment for one of them because one of them has got to lose, sadly.
Beautiful shot here by Michelle Lee.
Service over.
That's definitely one of her favourite shots, this reverse drop shot here. And is stretching Liang Xiaoyu to the maximum.
Oh, yes. Well, really wasn't high enough to get over the tall Michelle Lee. 175, that's 5'9".
But the major difference between these two players, I think, is going in favour of Michelle Lee, is that she is much more powerful in her attack than her opponent is. Her attack is better. So what happens here is that Liang really has to work very hard. She's got to fight every single point. She's got to get it back, and eventually trying to force Michelle Lee like this to make a mistake. She will not play outright winners in the same way as Michelle Lee will play them.
Well, she's been highly successful in recent times as Michelle Lee, first badminton player from North America at the Macau Grand Prix last year to reach a final. No other North American badminton player has reached a women's singles final at a Grand Prix gold event. This year at the All England, she caused a bit of a sensation as well, didn't she?
She got to the quarters.
Quarter final, first Canadian to reach the quarter for 35 years since Wendy Carter. It's going back to our era.
That's why I can remember. You know what happened a long, long time ago? That's what you can remember. And what was her maiden name? I know that.
Clarkson.
That's correct. Just testing you.
Now, that's what you're talking about, isn't it, Morton?
It is.
It's that ability to play a winner, because we've been singing the praises of Liang Xiaoyu and saying what beautiful movement, what wonderful technique and disguise on her shots, but she doesn't have the killer weapon.
Exactly, and that's what I was trying to say, and we have a very fine example of it here. And a good start for Michelle Lee, 7-4 up, is as much as you can ask for, I think. And here we see it again.
Yeah.
And a follow-up. Yep.
Very well played.
8-4.
Well, I hear that His Royal Highness, Duke of Wessex, Prince Edward, is watching the badminton. I hope he's enjoying this as much as we are. I'm sure he is. He's a great supporter of badminton, patron of Badminton Scotland.
Service
over. 5-8. Oh dear.
6.
Oh, that was an easy mistake. Very nice pressure on that backhand. That one there. Very nicely played. And then the simple one. It was a mistake.
Service over. 9-6.
Well, it'll be quite understandable if they're both feeling the nerves. And two Singapore coaches, Liu Qingdong and Chow Yongju.
A good shot as well. Six. It looks very simple, very, very easy, but it's actually quite well disguised. See here how we get it there. She's opening up the racket head and play it straight. That's almost a little bit too easy in my book.
Yeah, 5-point advantage for Michelle Lee at the mid-game interval.
She's always ready to go front and back, but you make her do that and then you cross her and you get a ton of points. Do you know what I mean? Because she'll hit it short and then use the cross. Otherwise, just keep focused and just keep a little bit faster than she is. What you're doing. Okay? Good job. Let's go. Good going.
Good job. Let's go, says Ram Naya, the national coach.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds.
Wonderful way that the players, you can see on that replay how they just sink down as they want to change direction. They just sink down a bit lower, bend the knees a bit more, and then push in a different direction.
Yes,
wonderful movement.
And it's not very often we have the pleasure of having so good slow motion pictures as what we have here in this tournament. That's one of the favourites, one again, once again, that's going wide. But look at that cross court from the backhand side.
7-11.
Well.
No doubt the call was right.
Yeah. Michelle Lee just asking for some perspiration to be mopped from the court surface. Angle on the net shot, but she had played the smash, she'd anticipated the straight reply. Look at that stretch forward from Liang Xiaoyu.
Mm.
Once again, it's the attack of Michelle Lee. And I think the Canadian coach, Ram, really had a good point when he said, you know, we keep it tight, we work it, and when the opportunity is there, we go cross-court. And somehow I feel that the taller Michelle Lee is really having an advantage here because Liang is so small and she can't really get to them.
Mm.
So she's got to work it in a different way at the moment, as I see. She's got to find some answers here, and I will try to search with her in terms of what I think she should do.
Liang just 5'5".
And she's severely under pressure.
Mm.
See again, once again, it's the cross court that's making the problem here for Liang.
So a 7-point advantage now. Mm. Losing the mental discipline.
15-7.
Cardinal sin to make an error on the return of serve, really.
And that's interesting because when she played the team event against India, that was the bronze medal.
Yeah.
I expect it's a very, very good match against Sindhu. And she played a good first game. But in the second game, she actually folded.
Mm.
And that's what I think I see now here, that the mental strength, being only 18 years old, haven't really played international top senior badminton yet. I think she's in trouble here. Great potential, but there's still some work to be done.
Oh, my goodness, that is just delightful.
Service open. 16-8.
Perfect net shot. Look at the way the shuttle's absolutely upside down.
Yeah. And it was played without delay.
Mm.
Service
over. 9-16. It's going wide.
That's better.
10-16.
From Liang.
Yeah, Liang. Xiao Yu really have to find the answer, and in my book, again, it's got to be pace. She's got the pace, and she's got to play that pace. And at the moment, it's too slow. There's not enough pressure on the shots she's playing. So she's got to play a lot more pace. Look at that here. Once again, very nicely played by Michelle Lee. That lift cross-court. Once again, it was a cross-court shot doing the damage to this one here. She has to go into the net to cover that one, and then she's too small.
Service over.
Mm. 11-7. One of the coaches has disappeared.
Yeah, but he's gone on to the other court where the men's doubles is playing.
Ah, yes.
This time it did not work out.
17.
She played it earlier in this match, and that time it worked really well, that delay, because she's opening up that, look at that, still catching her opponent on it,
yeah.
But it just didn't go over. This is much better. Slight hesitation.
What a rally. How many times? This time on the backhand side from Michelle Lee. The little hold before the net shot. In fact, there's, I mean, that backswing, to all intents and purposes, it looked as if she was going to flick the shuttle.
Yeah.
Lovely play.
Yeah, very nice touch. She's got on the shots here. She will be very good in the Danish league. You're laughing. She is going to play in the Danish league.
Is she really?
She is. It's a little bit of bonus information for you.
Oh, goodness me, what you've got. You've got all the hot gossip. That's gone
She's
wide.
She's playing for one of the top three clubs in just south of Copenhagen. 18. And that's a little bit of a scoop.
Well, in all honesty, Michelle Lee, you're talking about.
Yes, coming, it's Michelle Lee.
Yeah,
yes.
The fact that she's based in Canada. Canada is such a huge country. I guess being based in Europe and based in Denmark is probably going to help develop her badminton anyway, regardless of whether she's playing for a rival club of yours.
Yeah, regardless. Never mind. She's more than welcome, and it's obviously good for all. I think it's good for her. Mm. And it's good for the Danish players as well to have someone to train with on a daily-day basis.
Yeah. Well, just 4 points adrift now. Oh, that is magnificent, isn't it? We were talking about that glorious backhand where she looked as if she was going to flick it deep and just played the net shot. Yes. Very next time, she does play the flick.
Exactly the same action.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you cannot see what's coming. You have to sense it.
Yeah. 2 points away from this opening game, Michelle Lee.
Liang Xiaoyu has done well here, closing the gap. Only 16-19 now. And maybe that's an indication of what's to come in the second game.
Yeah, she was 8 points adrift, wasn't she? That's great length. Well, Liang Xiaoyu doesn't agree with the line call. Oh, it was out too. My goodness, mate. Oh, Michelle Lee, awfully lucky there. Because that incorrect line call has given her game point opportunities. First time of asking. 21-16 in just under 20 minutes of play. Well, as far as Liang Xiaoyu is concerned, I thought the way she finished that opening game, she was trying to be a little more positive. Morton, do you think that's the tone we're going to see at the start of the second?
I think so. That's what I mentioned earlier. I think she's really coming out now here and then hopefully picking up from where she ended in that first game.
So the opening game, Michelle Lee, the number three seed from Canada, 21-16, but it was a very good opening game.
Love all. Representing South Africa,
Michelle Lee has, of course, been playing mixed doubles as well in the individual event. She and Adrian Liu lost yesterday. And I always wonder, Morton.
Blessing in disguise.
Yes, I was going to say that.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah.
They will never win a mixed doubles medal, I think.
No.
And she's got a great chance here of winning even a gold medal in the women's singles. So go for it, focus and concentrate.
So the luck of the net court. Yeah, but look how early she's taking that shot, creating her own luck.
Yes, but the steepness of that smash is not good enough. It's too flat.
From Liang.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There was a winning opportunity there for Liang. I think that really was the missed opportunity.
Shot again. Yeah.
Well, she's simply just playing better, honestly.
Yeah. And I tell you what, I think she's really improved since the last time I really watched her, Michelle Lee, is her net play.
Yeah, she's got very nice disguise. She's got a very nice touch. Very often, it clipped the tape, every single shot is so tight. She's really playing well. Good power, good deception. That's the two major differences between these two players.
Well wide.
Yeah, and then that insecurity is setting in. That's what we saw against Sindhu as well in the second game.
Well, Well, she made the error, but to be honest, if it had gone over, it would have been an outright winner because Liang Xiaoyu...
She totally stopped.
Yeah.
Service over. 6-2.
This time for the Singaporean.
But that's what she's got to do. That shot there, she's got to start doing stuff like this. Not obviously hitting the tape, but she's got to be more proactive. She's got to go in and take that initiative. And if she doesn't do it, she will not win.
That's just magnificent. You know, Morten, I've been thinking about something you said a little earlier. And you said... Liang Xiaoyu simply isn't tall enough. She couldn't get the angle. And that's been bothering me. It's really been bothering me. Because, you know, I'm thinking, well, some of the world's top players are about her height.
Yes.
So, in other words, what do they have different to Liang Xiaoyu? Now, is it that they have more disguise on their overhead? That they... can make their opponents just hesitate slightly, so then their downward shots become more effective? Or what is it? Because, you know, being 5'5" is not necessarily a problem in badminton.
No, I totally agree. But when you combine that with the grip she's got, then you're in trouble. She's having the grip she's got is very... steady, it's good, but she's not changing, she's not using her fingers, she's not changing grip from shot to shot and so on. And she really has to learn that.
Yeah, and also, now you've mentioned it, and I look at Liang Xiaoyu. Yeah, in badminton terms, it's a little bit panhandle?
A little bit, yes.
Yeah.
That's the word.
And also... I think the grip is too short. You see a lot of the top singles players, and the end of the handle, you can't see when they're holding it. You can with her.
She's holding it high.
Yeah.
10-3.
Yeah. That, in badminton terms, is what we call a short grip. Well, this is 11, runaway at the moment for Michelle Lee. An 8-point advantage at the mid-game interval on a run of 5 straight points. Yeah, look at that. That gives us a wonderful example of exactly what you've been talking about, Morten. Itself is very interesting, isn't it? Morten, the coach is not saying a lot to either player.
No, I think I would say the Singaporean bench has not been giving a lot of advice during the whole tournament or the last 8 days we've been here, but the Canadians have,
11,
and I think they're quite comfortable in their position at the moment.
Well, not surprised, a game in 11-3 up.
Service over. 4-11. 5-11.
Oh, now, look at that. That's much more the normal sort of grip in badminton, isn't it?
Yeah, that's why she's... And she's using the fingers. She's got more finger power. She's using the finger, changing her grips all the time. And that's why we can see she can do these small flicks and stops and turns and twisters and all that. And the other grip just doesn't...
Yeah. So it's interesting, isn't it? Because, I mean, badminton players, you can see that light grip, the forefinger there quite high up on the grip. Tennis players in general tend to hold the racket in the palm of the hand. Mm. Badminton players hold the racket in the fingers.
Yes.
Six,
and
12.
Yes, but as far as Liang is concerned, it's almost like when we talk about a panhandle grip, it's a bit like a Western grip for... Yes. A tennis player.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you. I'm learning a lot here in English.
Seven. Well.
But yet again, a little good comeback here. 7-12.
Hmm. So much for my belief that her coach didn't really give her much instruction, whatever he said. Oof, goodness me.
Service over. 13,
yeah, whatever he said,
seven.
He's obviously said the right thing, but this doesn't look... Oof, goodness me. Well, they're so... So supple, these badminton players nowadays.
See, that's more. That's more the spirit. Now she's, she seems to be a lot more determined. She's got to make a comeback here. And I like that spirit. Look at that.
Mm.
That expression. She wants to come back. She's definitely not giving up yet.
This has got a different feel to it now.
Yes.
Well, the mid-game interval, she was 8 points adrift. Now just 3 points the difference.
Look at the coach here. Very fine picture.
That's gone long as well.
11,
yeah.
13.
And there's far more...
There's fire.
Exactly.
And I noticed that on 7 and 8.
Service over. 14-11.
But Michelle Lee just have to continue. I know that the lead is not as big as what it was at the mid-game interval, but she just have to do the same. Carry on. Play, play, play. It's still her opponent that's got to show that she's got the ability to win it. Take it away from Michelle Lee. And suddenly here we saw a disguise shot as well.
Yeah.
12-13. well, 13, well,
well.
14.
Well, well, well. Yes, all right. Well, well, well. What a change of event here.
Yeah. And Coach Ram Mayer from Canada is all of a sudden looking very concerned. That's landed in. She's back level.
14 all.
This is extraordinary. 11-3 down at the mid-game interval. Well, I apologise to the Singapore coach, because whatever he said, he's worked wonders.
Nice, good smash. Yeah. Very nice smash.
Service over. 15-14.
So now it'd be interesting to see, being 11-3 down, catching up at 14 all. You know how that works. You sort of relax because you've made this enormous comeback. Does that mean that Michelle Lee suddenly get 3 points or 17-14 or something like that? She's got to watch out.
Yeah. So often see it, don't we? It's almost as if a player thinks that the hard work is done, that they're back level, and as you say, just a little bit of relaxation, and then all of a sudden that's the moment when opponents can pounce and open up a gap again.
Yeah, they run away one more time.
Oh, it's called wide.
16.
I was surprised at that, Morton. No overall from the umpire.
Oof. On the line.
Yeah, that was in. That was in. Oh, my goodness. Gone long.
17-40.
Urging his player on. Well, what was it you just said, Morton?
Yeah.
Danger of winning next three points from 14 all.
Yes.
Well, Michelle Lee already this year has enjoyed success. She won the Canadian Grand Prix event. Nice to have a home winner.
Thank you.
The Canadian Grand Prix reached the final in Peru. And that's landed well in. And that's an important point, actually,
18,
Morton, because
14.
You can get in the habit of winning and you can get in the habit of losing. You know, and for Michelle Lee, the fact that she's been to tournaments, that she's been able to win, get through to the final, come to a major games like this, she will be full of confidence and she will know how to win. The fact is, Liang Xiaoyu has only played 4 senior tournaments.
Hasn't really tried it.
No.
I agree. But she should have played like this from the word go, first game. Love all play. This would have been a completely different match.
Well, it's, I suppose it emphasises 19, the point that she's only 40. Played 4 senior tournaments. I mean, she hasn't got the experience. She's 18 years of age.
Yeah, give her some good years and we will see a good player here.
Yeah. Well, don't give up on it yet, Morton.
No, don't give up. But
2 points away from a place in the quarterfinal. Unlikely that the youngster from Singapore can come back now. play. Isn't that gorgeous?
Match point,
yes.
14.
Tumbling the shuttle.
I was surprised that Liang could stay in this rally for this long. Many very good shots from Michelle Li here.
Well, having a battle back to 14 all, Liang Xiaoyu has fallen away again. Not of that, it's been due to this lady's good play. Match point opportunities. Oh, finds the line, well saved.
Service over. 15-20.
That's out.
16.
Couldn't happen 20. Again, could it?
No, no. But you never know. No, I don't think so. I think Michelle Li has got too many options, too many shots to play. One have to come through.
Yeah. There we go. Third match point opportunity. Symmetry in the scoreline. 21-16, 21-16. And Michelle Li, the number three seed, duly takes her place in the quarterfinal.
Match won by Michelle Li.
42 minutes needed.
21-16, 21-16.
And for Liang Xiaoyu, well, she will have learned an awful lot from her experience here in Glasgow. First of all, in the team competition, when in the semi-final against Malaysia, she beat Ti Ying Yi. And the semi-final went down to the fifth and final match. But for Michelle Li, well, she would have been a little nervous, I guess, before the start of this, because this could have potentially been a very, very tricky match. Canadian flag, Canadian fans will be absolutely delighted. But I have to say, the way Michelle Li approached this match and the way she really took it to her opponent from the start was a delight to watch. Confirmation, 21-16, 21-16 in 42 minutes.
Michelle Li.
Well, when both these players came on to court, Morton and I turned to each other and we had a little smile on our faces, didn't we? We'd been so looking forward to this. And I suppose the opening game, in a way, didn't live up to our expectations because the Canadian was so accurate with her attacking play.
Yeah, I totally agree. It was a little bit of a disappointment, this first game, and look at this. How well Michelle Li played that first game. But suddenly in the second, we saw a complete comeback from the young girl from Singapore, Liang Xiaoyu. She was 14-7 down, and then suddenly it was 14-all, and we sort of thought maybe she can make it. But she did not. Michelle Li took the remaining 7 points. Got all the way to match points, 6 in a row, and then on the third point of asking, she got the last and the final match point.
Yeah, it was a good performance all round, wasn't it, Morton? And
it was a good match.
Yeah. The moment of victory. 21-16 in 42 minutes.